Hello friends, in this video we will look at the missionaries and cannibals problem. It is a very famous problem in artificial intelligence, and let us look at the introduction and then we will look at the coding for missionaries and cannibals in Prolog. So let us begin. In missionaries and cannibals, first of all we have the definition of the problem. For those of you who are not familiar with the problem, there is a river flowing and there are missionaries and cannibals on the left side of the bank, where the missionaries are represented by the black triangles and the cannibals are represented by the circles. Now, missionaries are God-fearing people and cannibals are people who eat human flesh. So, if in case the number of cannibals is going to outnumber the number of missionaries, then the cannibals can eat the missionaries. So, therefore, the number of missionaries should always be equal or larger than the number of cannibals. And with this condition, we have to make them cross this river. And this boat which we have here can carry only two people at a time. Now, we have to ensure that at any time on the left or the right side of the bank, the number of missionaries is never less than the number of cannibals. So, with this condition, we have to make all of them cross the river. So, this is the introduction to the problem, that is the problem definition. Now, so we have, the goal is to move all the missionaries and the cannibals across the river. Constraint is that the missionaries can never be outnumber the number of cannibals on either side. The cannibals can never outnumber the number of missionaries. Actually, it is written reverse. Then state is the initial states and the operators. Let us look at them. The initial state is that all the missionaries and all the cannibals and the boat is on the left side of the bank. So we will use a state which is constituted of three numbers. The first number represents the number of missionaries on the left side. The second number will represent the number of cannibals on the left side, and the third number will represent whether the boat is on the left or the right side. So if the value is 1, that means boat is on the left side, and if the value is 0, it means the boat is on the right side. And then the exhaustive set of operations that can be performed on this number of missionaries and cannibals is, you send one missionary to the right side of the bank, or you send one cannibal, or you send two missionaries or two cannibals, or one missionary and one cannibal, depending on the seating capacity of the boat. Only two people can travel. One can also travel. So either you send one missionary, one cannibal, or two missionaries, two cannibals, or one missionary and one cannibal. So this is the exhaustive set of states that we have. Now, what is the search method? Let us look at the graph straight away. So now here we can look at the graph. Since we have 5 choices, either we send one missionary, or we send one cannibal, or we send two missionaries, we send two cannibals, or we send one missionary, one cannibal. Based on this, this graph has been generated. In the first choice, if we send one missionary, we will be left with two missionaries and three cannibals on the left side of the bank, which is a danger situation, therefore it is marked in red. Then if we send one cannibal, then that is an acceptable move, that is a safe state, because the number of missionaries is more than the number of cannibals. Then if we send two missionaries, again it becomes dangerous because the number of cannibals is 3 and they can eat the single missionary who is left behind. Then if we have sent two cannibals, that is also an acceptable state because the number of missionaries is in the safe state. Then if we send one missionary and one cannibal, similarly, now if we send one missionary and one cannibal, we will be left with two missionaries and two cannibals, which is a safe state. Then the red nodes we will not expand further, the white nodes we will expand. So when we expand the white node now, and the one cannibal has been sent, now the boat has to be brought back to the left side, and therefore that same cannibal will come back. So we are generating the same state as the previous state, and that is why it is marked as yellow. So we will not pursue this branch. Then again, in this option where we have sent two cannibals, we can go further. How we can go further? We can send, we can get back one of the cannibals. So that is an acceptable state. It's white in color. Then both the cannibals can come back, but it will generate the same state as the initial state. So we will not follow this further. Then if we have two cannibals and two missionaries, I mean two missionaries and two cannibals, then if we send two cannibals again, they will come back, then this node is not acceptable, which is shown here in yellow. And if now we will have one of the cannibals come back, bring the boat back, that is not acceptable. And if we have one of the missionaries bringing the boat back, we will get 3-2-1, which is an acceptable move. Now, we will further expand these nodes. So again, we will keep on simply taking the operators, whether we can send one missionary, one cannibal, two missionaries, two cannibals, one missionary, one cannibal. This way, this whole graph will get solved and eventually we will get the solution. So all the white nodes which are present at the bottom, they are the solutions, and this is one of the paths from which we are getting the solution. So let us look at the Prolog code, which can help us in generating this type of a solution. First of all, let us look at the various predicates that we have. We have a solve predicate which does not receive any arguments, and this is the place which we will use from the prompt in Prolog in order to call this particular program. So we will just type solve dot on the prompt. And what it will do is, it will calculate the initial state. And how it will calculate the start state? We have already defined a predicate at the bottom. You can see here, we have initial state as 3-3-1, which means 3 missionaries, 3 cannibals on the left side of the boat. The boat is on the left side. So this start is going to take the value from this predicate. Then we call the breakfast search for searching of the solution. In this, we will pass the start state as the initial node that we have, and solution is what the breakfast search is going to return as an answer. And finally, we will write the solution on the console, and we will simply come out of the logic. So the main processing is taking place in the breakfast search. Now, in order to call the breakfast search, we have to define the safe states. Now, the safe states are, if the number of missionaries is 0 and the whatever is the number of cannibals, it doesn't matter. This is a safe state. If all the missionaries are present at the same place, whatever is the number of cannibals, it doesn't matter. Or it has to be same. The number of missionaries has to be equal to the number of cannibals. So, these are the 3 safe states. All other states are not safe. Now that we have defined the safe state, we have to define the goal and the initial. So initial state is 3-3-1. Goal state is 0-0-0. That means all the missionaries and cannibals are on the right side, and the boat is also on the right side. And in this goal state, if in case we receive a path in the goal, then how we will find out the goal state? Using the last node in the path, we will match that with the goal node, and if both are same, then this is the solution state. So this is how we define the goals. Now what we have is the series of movements. So in case you want to send the two missionaries, then what you will do, you will receive M1, C1 as the number of missionaries and cannibals on the left hand side. And eventually you will have M2 number of missionaries, and you can see here we are decreasing the number of missionaries by 2. And we are then finding that the state is safe. Similarly, we have defined for all the states, 2 missionaries from right to left, left to right. So total 10 cases will be formed like this. And then we have the printing algorithm, which will explain how the states are taking place. And in this, print solution is going to call the explain function. It will just print how many number of missionaries and cannibals are traveling and where the boat is. And then finally, we have the breakfast definition, which we have to use. In this breakfast definition, first one is that what we are going to receive, we are going to receive a set of paths, and we will return the path as a solution in case the path is the goal path. If it is not the goal path, then we will extend it further. We will take the last path that has been saved and we will expand that path, find new paths, and then append the new paths to the list of already existing paths, and then we will call breakfast search again. Now in this, the most important function is the extend function. Extend function, what it will do is it will take the latest node from the queue of paths that has been accumulated, and it will find out from the node we can move to a new node using the move function which we have defined. And whatever new node will get calculated, if it is not already a member of the existing paths that we know, then we will add it to the new paths, and extend will return this set of new paths to the breakfast search function. So I hope this code is clear to you. I'm going to paste this code in the description box in case somebody wants to use it and execute it. So this is the explanation of the Missionaries and Cannibals program. And I hope this video is useful to you. And if you like my channel, please subscribe to it and recommend it to your friends and people who are into computer science and they want to learn Prolog. Thank you very much.